Hey there, y'all. This is Lightning Bolt Forever, back with more Doom 3 BFG Edition Resurrection of Evil. Last time, we put our new Berserk ability in the artifact to the test, and we tried to get to Delta, but unfortunately the monsters blocked our path, so now we must go through PHOBOS to get to Delta, and that's what we're doing now. So, we've stepped into reception here, and everything is, everything's relatively quiet, but you can definitely hear some Hellspawn lurking around. And let's go ahead and collect up that soul right there for the artifact. And, yeah, just go ahead and make our way on into research. Hey! Hey! I see you! You're not fooling anybody! Come back here! Anyway. The gallery, what's in here? Okay. That I don't like all that. Let's go around here. What's back? Oh, armor? Any traps when we pick it up? No. Not right away at least. Yeah. Anyway, let's leave there. Let's just step out of there. Let's go into here. And there's some shells over there, so we'll grab them. And, yeah, is there anything... Hey! Hey! Oh, yeah, they definitely know we're here. They're tormenting us, you know. They're plotting. Anyway, we gotta get into that office because there's a PDA in there. More importantly, there's also a switch in there to allow us to progress. Let's see, research security is locked. Sector B is locked, so we'll go into A. Got some chain gun ammo here. We'll be meeting a new enemy in this place also. And it is actually a new enemy. It is not one that we have seen yet. So, hold on to your butts, because it's going to get wild. Okay. All that's taken care of in there. And here we got the boardroom meeting. We got the boardroom in here, the meeting room. Somebody's got some really bad handwriting. Either that or I don't have this thing turned up on max graphical setting. Anyway, PDA of James Owens. And come on, a PDA in an office room. Did you think that was going to go unnoticed? So we'll use... Yeah, there we go. We'll use the rocket launcher. Nice. Got rid of the Vulgar. The Vulga. And... Oh, okay. And reload. And, wah, there we go. Lovely. No damage taken. Alright, so let's take a quick pit stop and read this thing, if there's anything to read. Let's see, James Owens, soda consumption. Please be courteous in the lounge. Ba-ba-da-ba-da. Viktor Karkov, planning poker game. Virus? Yeah, haven't you heard it's going around? No, I'm just kidding. Oh, I need to stop with all that. Anyway, let's see. Elizabeth McNeil. So those... Come on, guys. Try to show them more. Bolted to the floor? Oh, we gotta see this. Hang on a second. Because, see, look at this. You can pick up any other office chair with the grabber. Yeah? Yep, they're bolted down. They ain't going nowhere. Dr. McNeil was serious. Sounds like the Phobos guy's been making trouble for her. Anyway, let's get this out. Let's go out here. And... What's that? Whoa, wow. Okay, well... It definitely shoots many more fireballs at a time than the Mancubus. Okay. Wow. What are you? Ugh, yeah, God. That was the new enemy. That was the Bruiser. And they're tough. They're pretty tough. And we'll be seeing more of them later on, and I'll let you get a better view at them, or view of them. But yeah, they are, they're heavy hitters. And, hey, look who it is.
God, it's good to see you. There's so much I need to explain, but we don't have much time. The artifact is a gateway from hell, much like the one that Betruger opened with the teleporters in the Delta Labs. With the artifact, though, as long as it resides in our dimension, there's always the danger of it being awakened, and then the other invasion. The ancients knew it, and now we know it. It must be returned to the source of its evil in order to be destroyed. They couldn't do it, so they locked it away and fought to their death. You can use the Delta teleporter to return the artifact to Hell for good. I know this sounds crazy, but it's the only way. The important thing right now is getting the Phobos teleporter online. There are four core systems that must be shut down before I can reroute the power to the teleporter. Take this. You'll need it to get to the pumping station. Now go.
Cool. So we have met up with Dr. McNeil, and we have the access key to the pumping station. We've got to shut down all these places to put the end of the plot of these monsters here. All right, so let's move on. Let's keep moving. So yeah, Dr. McNeil there. Her voice may sound a little familiar. She is actually voiced by Jennifer Hale, who's done a lot of work with video game voice work. She's also most notably Bastila Shan in Star Wars Knights of the Old Republic, which we have played on this channel before. So, yeah. Nice little bit of trivia there. Anyway, let's go through here. Let's get some... We'll gladly take some more rockets. And we also picked up the plasma rifle last time, but we are going to use it. But... not until we pick up some more ammo for it. So, I guess I am full of everything. I heard a noise in here, in this room, like last time I was practicing this level, but, like a monster noise, but it doesn't seem to be going this time. I guess he went to sleep or something. Anyway, let's head outside. And, we got forgotten ones. Oh boy. And we have forgotten them, because, you know, they were only in the first two levels of the game, and then after that, they just kind of disappeared. But, anyway, we're back on the Mars surface here. And we can grab some air canisters, and let's see, what's over here? Chain gun? Yeah. Revenant! Ooh, there we go. And another. Yes, bring them. Bring them out. Let me kill them all. Alright, let's go up these stairs here. And we'll get the grabber back out. We're going to have more forgotten ones. And just drop him over the edge. There we go. And let's see. There's more, I believe, over this way. So we can go up this ladder. Yep. If not, if for nothing else, then the rockets. Because, you know, they're rockets. And rockets are very nice to have. Anyway, let's go inside. And the door will close, and yes, the air is recycled, and we have made it to the pumping station. So we got to go ahead and shut this thing down here. Shut this thing on down.
Pump station disengaged. Pump station shut down.
Sensors are showing the pumping station offline. It's one down. Now shut down auxiliary power to the research complex.
Yes, ma'am. All right, so let's get this out, because look, the lights have gone dark here. Yeah, we know what's up. We know what's up. And there should be... yep. Come on around the corner there. And eat a rocket. There's one more revenant up there. Nice. All right. So everybody's dead, and we have a PDA right here of Seth Killian. Let's see. Let's kind of get away from all the noise. Stand right about here. Let's see what old Seth has to say here.
This is maintenance technician Seth Killian. I'm looking for anyone that's survived, but... what the... I don't know what these things are after, but... They're killing everything. I gotta get out of here. I'm gonna try and take the maintenance tunnels to Mars City to get an emergency evac. Find this, and it probably...
Oh, poor Seth. They got him. Which, you know, we already knew, because we saw him right over there. But, yeah. Back outside we go. Yeah, those PDAs that always... ooh, nice. Cacodemon killed with his own lightning ball. Kind of sad when you think about... oh, jeez. It's kind of sad that they're, their cacodemons are just that weak against their own firepower, but, you know? Eh, survival of the fittest with these hellspawn out here. And, of course, one super shotgun blast. They're weaker than the original Cacodemons. The original Cacodemons could take at least two. Anyway, enough babbling about that. We'll cycle the airlock. Go back in. Whoa! And we got a nasty surprise waiting for us here. And that's it. For that surprise, at least. Nice. Those guys, and that guy, and then this guy. Alright, yes, the Vulgars are popping out everywhere. So through here is blocked. We cannot go that way. So let's get this out. Because we're going to have... Oh, boy. We're going to have... yeah, we're going to have some machine gunners. Not the craziest thing we've ever seen, but, you know, they're going to be just filing on out of their little, other little hiding spots here. But that's the end of them. And, what kind of magazines we got on the counter here? Let's see, Guns and Nachos. Booty. And there's another game hog. Let's see what's over here. More booty? Yes, lots of booty. UAC? Let's see. Oh, what?
Super Turbo Turkey Puncher 3.
Ugh, what do you want from me? Anyway, let's, yes. You can always count on Super Turbo Turkey Puncher 3 to survive the impending hellpocalypse here. Oh, can't get in the bathroom? Oh, well. Oh! One more? Oh, yeah, there he is. Sweet. Alright. We all loaded up here. I think we're all loaded up. There we go. You know what? Oh. Yeah, I don't feel like dealing with him. So you can eat a rocket. And we got PDA back here of Keith Nordzy. Mr. Nordzy. Let's see. No audio logs. Let's see. Artifact shipments. I'm expecting another shipment of artifact. Artifacts, plural, from the Erebus complex this week, blah blah blah. Your bridge code has been changed to 281. Important information, people. Bridge codes. So let's go through here. Rockets, which are always nice. Let's see, nothing else there.
Warning, automated turret guns online.
Well, that ain't gonna be a problem, because we got code 281.
Attention, automated turret guns offline.
Splendid.
Service bridge now operational.
Hmm. I'm hearing footsteps here. Who's skulking around in here? Whoa! Bah, what the heck? Yeah, you can just stay down, you know? Nice! Plenty of plasma ammo. Lots of plasma ammo. So now we can use it here without fear of running out.
Access granted.
And we can activate the access lift. And that's gonna go right on over here. And, if you remember that door that was locked earlier? Well, that's where we're going to go through next to get to the lift. So now, yes, now that we've done all that, there's going to be... Whoa! Forgot he was that close. Oh, my God. I always forget about that one. I don't know why. Oh, God. Yes, the Vulgars, they want us dead. They want us dead so bad. But, you know, it's just not gonna happen. Old Space Marine here, he is just too strong. Oh, well. Not if he runs out of ammo, though. Why does the Revenant sound like he's just like an old man complaining about stuff? He's like, back in the day, there wasn't all these hellspawn, and Revenants moved a lot faster in their video games. I don't know. I don't know what I'm saying. Anyway, let's get back to where we were going originally here. Through these doors. Health and armor. Lots of it, so we'll activate the lift. And we're going back the way this thing came from. Alright. And we will go on through here. Oh. That. We've heard that noise before. Could this be... Could this be what we think it is here? Uh-oh. Yep, there he is. It was he's big. Oh, he's really big. Yeah, it was only a matter of time until we fought the last of the the last of the three brothers here. The Hell Brothers. So here he is, the Invulnerability Hunter. And he's actually pretty simple the way he works. All you, whoa, yeah, watch out for his shockwave attack there. That can throw you off. Really throws the camera off more than anything. But yeah, he'll do that. He'll throw fireballs at you, or lightning balls at you, or electricity. And he's pretty simple. All you gotta do is just shoot him. Just keep on shooting him until he starts electrifying like that. And then open up each core as the control panel turns green. And yeah, it kind of hinted that in his intro cutscene there. But all you gotta do is just open up each of the cores as they become available. When the control panel turns green, shoot it, blow it up, and that will weaken him, allowing him to, allowing you to kill him more easily. But each time he goes to do this, oh yeah, he is invulnerable, given his name. So yes, let's, yeah, don't get too close to the cores either, because they can hurt you. And we're just gonna hang back here. Let's use this again. Yeah, it's best not to be on the same plane as him, because he's more apt to doing that shockwave attack. But he never leaves the center of the room, which is pretty convenient. Alright, let's grab this, open up the final core here. And two rockets each. Oh goodness, yeah. Don't want to get hit by that attack. And I think we will switch back to old Super Shoddy here and finish him off with that. Because he doesn't have a whole lot left to go. That's right. Yes. Give me your power. I shall absorb your power.
Auxiliary power down. Rerouting. Good. Now take the Skytram to the reactor complex. You can access the last two systems from there.
Alrighty. So we have defeated the last of the three Hell Hunters. And with that, we have filled in all of the little nodes on the artifact there. And, we now have the power of invulnerability in the artifact, which is just... it's just so awesome. So let's leave here. We need to get back to the Skytram. But, yes, this... it's,
Bye.
Yes, it's just, it's crazy how powerful the artifact is now. I mean, it's all filled up. I mean, dare I say, it may be overpowered. But, with the kind of, things we're going to be dealing with here soon. Well, yeah. That's, we'll get all the power we can take here. Anyway, lots of plasma. The last PDA of the level belongs to David Edens. Edens? And let's see. Email. Poker game this Friday. Let's see. Yes. Any word from UAC post? Alright. Please let me know. It's very important. Alright, well... yes, nothing, no codes or nothing like that. And let's go ahead and, unlock the doors here. And, uh-oh. Ah, there he is. That is the Bruiser. And he's got kind of a weird, it's like he's got a weird-looking mouth. It's like a computer screen with, like, a human mouth on it or something. It's very, very odd. But now that we've used, the artifact here. One punch. No damage. A glorious amount of speed. Yes, they are just... The monsters, they, yes, they will be bowing down to us here pretty soon. Well, maybe. I mean, I don't know if they'll be doing all that, but... point is... we are... just... you know... if we weren't a badass before, we definitely are with the artifact now. Anyway, back into the lobby. And we got revenants. Lots of revenants in this level. But we're also going to have a bruiser. So let's use this again. And see, watch this. Revenant, right? See how he shoots his fireballs at us? No damage. Come on. Oh, it wore off before he... spawned. Oh, goodness. Did I get him? Yeah, I got him. Alright, cool. Ugh. Now I need all this health here. Jeez. And, yes, before we go, I would like to charge up the artifact here. Absorb a couple more souls so that we're locked and loaded on our way out. Let's see. Any dead bodies lying around? Yep, there's one there. There's gotta be one in here somewhere, too. Ooh. Yep, there he is. Cuckoo. And with that, we're off. Let's get the hell out of here. So yes, back to the SkyTram. Yes, we did all that work just to go right back to where we were at the end of the last level. So anyway, yeah, next time on Resurrection of Evil, I will see you in Phobos Labs 3. Till then, this is Lightning Bolt Forever, and I'll see ya.